Welcome back. Well, behind every antique piece of furniture or gold coin, there lies a story. And our next guest is an expert in the history of such items and has been studying them for decades.
Decades. Our friends are here from Las Vegas Coin Company. They're back. Owner John Jankowski and collectibles buyer Scott DeLorish. It's great having both of you. Welcome in.
Thank you.
Hi.
It has been a year since you opened the store, huh?
A little over 14 months now,
wow.
I guess.
Yes. All right.
And you're still oozing annoyance, but go ahead.
Okay, listen, this is what I do. We kid, it's what we do.
He was giving you a little drama on the opening.
With the decades thing?
Yeah, but you have a lot of experience.
Great.
It's always dramatic when you come,
John.
How long
have you been buying collectibles? 6 months? You don't want to deal with that guy.
No.
Got it. Yeah, I have some interesting.
I love that. This is good.
Yes, we figured you would.
This is an old pocket watch.
Oh, my.
I don't know if we can, maybe you could.
Yes, I'd love
display that somehow.
May I pull it out?
Yeah,
okay,
of course.
Here we go.
And on it, that it hangs on that chain.
Yes.
There's a little bit of doodah thing there. Anyway, the interesting part is, and I hope this photographs on television, because it's in a glass frame, but the matriarch of this family is the woman in the middle.
The one wearing the watch.
Well, she's wearing the watch.
No way.
Her family members are on the back. It says 1885 to 1958, mother 1888 to 1954. So there's all this interesting part.
Wow.
And then, to top it all off, here's the original bill of sale for this watch.
No way.
Yeah. This is Chicago, July 18th, 1906.
How cool.
Gosh, I kind of have chills, I got to tell you.
She paid $21 in 1906. That was a lot of money.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Yes, it was. Sorry, I'm being selfish. I want to show that off. It's just amazing. I mean, if you think about it, this was sort of the original cell phone, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, this was connecting to her to time and what was going on.
And in those days, people didn't have the money we do today.
Yeah.
And so that would have been something passed down through the generations as it has.
Yeah.
And so since that was purchased in 1906, it's probably been in that same family until we bought it.
Absolutely.
And really just an interesting piece. Now, we did bring a few pieces of art as well. Interestingly enough, many celebrities who are not known for painting have painted.
Like whom?
Oh.
What a setup.
Well, like Adolf Hitler.
Oh, God.
You could buy an original piece.
Dark.
Okay.
All right.
But if you don't want him, we do have an Anthony Quinn
Original. Better.
Yeah,
okay.
We'll take
Got
the
it.
Win.
There
Thank
we go.
You.
And so that's an Anthony Quinn original. And so his art is available. Frank Sinatra has done works of art.
No kidding.
And
no
Scott was going to talk a little bit about a piece he has.
I love
as well.
The pink in that, actually.
It's kind of cool.
It'd be great for a lady.
And there are. That's the thing. There's one of the things is more musicians, in fact, than actors.
Yeah.
They're the ones, as we call them, artists. They do more than just music. You know,
yeah.
A lot of that's created right out of their mind, and they also put a lot of that on canvas. So Jimi Hendrix, maybe well known or not, he does some phenomenal art.
Some of the most amazing musicians see music as color.
Exactly right.
Which is why
if you saw some of the Jimi stuff. So aside from him, one of our favorites is Jerry Garcia. Some of the stuff he gets in,
yeah.
It comes in and goes out within days. So the one we brought today, however, we have an example that may be a little less known, David Bowie.
He was
actually a prolific artist. This is a piece from 1976. It's titled Child in Berlin. And this was a recollection of him. He lived there in Berlin, and upstairs from him was a dentist. So this was a little boy going up to his very first dental visit. A little bit apprehensive, So this is a unique piece. It's an artist proof in the bottom left corner there. You'll see it's an artist proof, which is actually even a little bit more limited than a typical run.
Wow.
And on the right side, this is a hand signed by David Bowie.
That's phenomenal.
So this is not an original, the piece of art that would be in a New York gallery for millions of dollars, but it is your next best thing. This is one of the first prints pulled from that original.
Taking a look at the signature there, we also want to give a shout out to
our...
To our interns.
Nate and Ricky, great display.
Nate and Ricky, look at that.
Don't look at that. All right.
They're making
no shrugging. That's very expensive. Don't listen. Be careful. And it's worth noting, I mean, you're a Las Vegas coin company, but it really just starts with coins. It really goes on from there.
Oh, we got all sorts of stuff.
Absolutely.
So I dropped by the store with Bill over the weekend, and what I got fascinated with, I love glass. And you have plenty of it.
She came in at a perfect timing of a fantastic collection. Unfortunately, someone's relative had passed, and her lifelong collection of Fenton glass.
Oh, wow.
Just beautiful, beautiful pieces, and JJ got to see some of that come in.
Well, you know, you just benefit. People spend their whole lives collecting these items.
Yes.
So they've picked what they think is the best of the best, and you've got different colors and things
Absolutely.
From different eras, and It's pretty fascinating.
It's remarkable. So if people want to be able to sell stuff or maybe find some really unique items to add to their collection, they can stop by and see
what you're about. These items are on display at the store, as are their other items, of course. And exactly like you said, come on in if you've got this type of stuff. We're strong buyers. Well, this is our forte. This is up our ballywick of what we're buying, as opposed to some other places that might just say, oh, we randomly buy generic or collectibles. We're very well versed with a nice group of people in there that specialize in a variety of items.
And you know, we really like what we do.
Yes?
We've run out of time, unfortunately.
Oh, nice. You know, you can see the stamp from the jeweler inside here.
Oh, how cool.
Yeah. Edward Alberti, Chicago.
Fantastic.
Oh, it's just fascinating.
Start to finish on that.
It really is amazing. It doesn't come in like that very often, so that's pretty cool.
No.
It's great having you, gentlemen.
Great.
Thank you so
much.
Great
to be here again, as always.
Las Vegas Coin Company. They're on Southeastern Avenue, right across from BJ's restaurant and brew house, right south of the 215. Their number and their website are right there on your screen as well. Las Vegas Coin Company, a proud sponsor of the Morning Glow.